Welcome to my channel. This channel is about cryptocurrencies. This channel is about opportunities. But before I get started, I want you to know, in no means am I your financial advisor.
Now stop the music and pay attention to this. This is going to be important. That's something I got to show you. Something I got to share with you. Somebody I'm going to share with you. Hold on. Hey, everyone. So, you know, I got on the phone, Crypto Face, and we've been talking a lot about BitMEX and trading and what's happening to some people. If I get this damn box out of the way. Crypto Face, are you there, buddy?
Yeah, I'm here, baby.
All right. So, you know, I started kind of warning people a little bit about BitMEX. You know, people watch us and they think it's so easy. And they think they could just jump into this, you know, and I want to take a minute and I want to talk to you about what you and I were talking about. I was telling you about mistakes that people make when they trade. Mm-hmm. And I told you about something I called the jumping jack flash. Right. Mm-hmm. And I said, it's when you're long on something and then all of a sudden you see it's going down and you flip and go short on it. Didn't you tell me something like that was just happening to you when we started laughing?
About 45 minutes ago.
Tell us what happened, buddy. And you're a pro.
So, entered a short position. This was right after we actually exited. My channel had a great, quick $50 swing going bearish. So we exited out of it. It was great, right? And then, of course, it's what's next? What's next now? What? So, entered another short entry. And not only did it go up, but it broke our channel that we had. I was flopping and groping a little bit. And to be honest, I closed the trade. And so for a loss, it was a small loss. And we're still profitable, even from the trade before, still profitable. Closed for a small loss. Now it's going back down again. Just goes to show you it happens.
Yeah, yeah. And, you know, we play these stupid disclaimers, everything. We tell people be careful. And, you know, this guy was a crypto soldier in my Discord. And those of you that are not my Discord yet, use the link down below, get in here, because I put a lot of stuff here. I even put daily trade updates. You could see everything I'm doing myself, but I want to share this with you. Hey, people, at first I didn't want to post this here, but after consideration with others, I think you should all be warned. You know, he private messaged me. And I asked him to go ahead and post it here and share it with everybody. I was in a long ETH position yesterday at 296, added to my position several times to lower my liquidation price. My last trade was executed at 11 a.m. today. And approximately 2 hours later, the price dropped to 274. 275 was my liquidation. So everything I put into crypto since April is gone. Let this be a warning to all of you guys. This was a final blow to my trading. I can't recover this since I have no money left other than a few bucks to buy food. Anyway, I took the risk. Now, look at his attitude. Okay, this guy got wiped out.
And he's not blaming you. He's not blaming anyone. Only himself.
Yep, look at this.
Respect.
There's certainly no one to blame because everyone carries, I hate this box here, the responsibility for his actions. Nevertheless, I'm devastated. This is me signing off. I wish you all better days to come. Now, if you excuse me, I'm going to pick up the pieces of my shattered dreams over and out. Fuck. Man. I mean, Crypto Face, I know you hear this stuff too. And it's just, I don't know how to explain to these people that you can't get rich in one trade.
Don't, you know what though? But like it's we told the people, like, you have to listen. It's just goes to show that, like, you can't, if we all took other people's knowledge passed down to us and applied it, we'd all be geniuses. Some things you just have to experience yourself. I mean, if we can tell you a million times to use 7x, 8x leverage, I guarantee you he was not using 7 or 8x leverage or 10. He was probably at 25, right? Maybe even 50. And he was long. Right. And so we got liquidated going long. And we can tell you a million times, I can tell you a million times to stay away from 25, stay away from 20.
If bro, you this want was to probably go like 33X, look at this. He was in at 296, right? And his liquidation was 275 after he kept adding money.
Oh, my Lord.
That's not enough of a spread. He must have went in too high and tried to correct it. This is rough.
Yeah.
And so I
listen. Whatever. Man, we all take swings. You'll be able to bounce back, but just learn moving forward.
Well, I'll tell you something, man. The thing with this is I coined it in one of my other videos. I called it overinvested-itis. And I want to tell people, if you can't tear yourself away from looking at the number, if you can't put in a trade and walk away from it without worrying about putting in a stop loss or any crap like that, that means that either two things happened. One of two things. Either you overinvested and you put more than you could afford to lose and you're worried about losing that money. I call that overinvested-itis. Or you aren't confident enough in the trade. Learn first. See, this is why when we talk about learning, there's only so much we could teach you here. Crypto Face, you just like you and I have been doing them together, I'm sure on your own, just like I have, you've been slammed with people emailing you for a one-on-one consultation, right?
Yeah, I actually have a couple today. I have a lot. This past few days, especially too, even yesterday when we went down, I'm getting a lot of messages. Yeah, a lot.
I know. And you and I have done a ton of calls together, and these people walked away feeling like we changed their lives. And I mean, what it costs to talk to both of us one-on-one, and we don't look at the clock. If we have to spend an hour with you or 45 minutes, whatever it is, don't mind that we call it a half hour because we'll stay with you. But, you know, you'll walk away with stuff that you can't learn in a course. Here's the thing. Every video you watch on YouTube, if you buy somebody's course, it's the same crap. You're getting a video.
Okay? Yeah. Or you're getting some text. It's not tailored to you. It's the standard BS. Yep.
This is both of us answering the questions you're embarrassed to ask. But not only that, both Face and I both have individual techniques and strategies we don't make public because people that are like haters and here just to make money on our backs and talk shit about us, they're not going to pay to talk to us. So we don't want them to make money on our knowledge. There are things like exchanges that front run the price on BitMEX and give you an edge. Okay. A lot of things that we use, even indicators that nobody else uses that I've used with my people and showed them exactly as we were on the phone, the direction the price was going to go.
There's only one consultation I've had where I got off the call with them thinking that they didn't get enough. And so like, and that one person, he's like brand new to everything, brand new to crypto brand. And so like, I had to try to jam all of my knowledge in the past 3 years into one 30-minute session. And like, he was having a hard time clicking buttons. And with that one guy, I'm following up with him. Other than that one guy, all the consultations have been amazing. Like they've been great. Everyone learned. We figured out what their strengths, what their weaknesses were, what they needed to work on. Also, a lot of times you're doing things right, but you need confirmation. You need to be told like, boom, that's exactly what you're supposed to be doing. That's how you're supposed to draw your lines, right? So a lot of you guys like have picked up a lot, learned a lot of stuff. The consultations, man, have been good. To the haters, screw the haters. And I'm getting haters from all sides of all people. I'm getting haters. Most people aren't haters, but the haters are the loudest. So most of everyone, like, love you, everything. I'm getting some from the Oracle side, the arbitraging side, the BitMEX. It's coming all around. But at the end of the day, most people are loving. We're kicking ass. We're learning. Some people have to go through hard lessons. You got to go through lessons. Crypto Psychonaut, bro, you just got BitMEX baptized, bro. You made big mistakes. You went long and you're man enough to admit it. Just now you know to never do it again. 10x leverage max, all that shit. Stop going long. People are going long, getting liquidated.
Yeah, it's true. And this is why, you know, a lot of people, they get on the phone with me and they want to discuss the core number trading that I tell them about. And, you know, if I turn around. So, bro, we both have specialties. Now, you know, I talk to people about this thing called core number trading, which I started using, bro.
I started using it 2 days ago. It's been kicking ass, too. Started using it 2 days ago, man. It's been working.
Bro, I swear to God, I'm so happy. We don't rehearse this shit. I'm so happy you came out and said that because I was going to say, all right, Face, listen, we had a private phone conversation. If you don't want to admit it, you know, you don't have to, but there's something the Oracle created. Okay, and are you using it? And I was going to ask you, and yeah. So you just put a little bit of money, okay, into core number trading, not a lot. Well, even in this shitty market, How long ago did you do it? Were you able to just pull out
And I have a suggestion too. So like you use the regular Coinbase, which is cool. And you know, I asked you about this a week ago. I'm like, what about the fees, dude? And you're like, oh, I don't care about the fees because you have more money than like a lot of people. So check this out, dude. Not only did I use your Coinbase Connect, but I used it. If I'm on the computer, on the pro one, like the old GDAX, I type in GDAX, it's pro.coinbase. And I think it charges me less fees. So I put in $4,000 and that was my like core number was $4,000. I used $4,000 and I've been averaging like 5-6% gains per day of like the mini swing trade. That's what Coinbase Connect is. It's like swing trading without having to look at the charts. When it goes below it, I do fill it up. So like when my $4,000, right? So like it'll go up to all at 4,030. I shave it off the top. Then like it would go lower. It would hit 3,990. And then I would look at a chart real quick maybe and fill up with 10 bucks. Then boom, it would go up 40 bucks. So like I'm putting money in. I'm playing with the swings. At the end of the day, I came up like 5%, but I was using GDAX, the pro Coinbase shit, instead of like the app on my phone. So I think it charges less fees, but I've been using it.
That's with Ethereum, bro. And I'm glad you said, because I know some trades you go balls to the wall, but I'm glad you said $4,000 because, you know, sometimes I don't think that way. And like, I can't really relate because I play with big, stupid numbers.
You're a baller, bro.
You know, whatever. But and I've shown people like 500,000 contracts on BitMEX and shit. But the thing is this, yeah, with $4,000, you could I want to show something really simple and sum this up for people. I mean, there's a lot of stuff we can talk about in the consultation, but the whole thing about core number trading, let's look at Ethereum from exactly 1 year ago to today, right? So a year ago, Ethereum was, I don't know, let's get as close as we can, 831. Look, it was actually higher than it is today, right? If you hodled, you would have got Ethereum at, let's say, 300. And you would have hodled for a year, and you would have 277 now. You see all of this when Ethereum went all this way up to the fucking moon? Everyone would have missed that. Hodling sucks. By using core number, every time you would have, for example, went over 4,000, you took that money, put it aside, took it, put it aside. I mean, you would have had like five times.
You would have been rich. Instead of just having what you bought in and then what it is now.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
As you go down, you could literally reinvest and compound. Nobody can take this away from your exit scam. And you don't have to put a penny out of your own pocket. And you're getting more and more, even if you don't catch the bottoms, you're getting more and more tokens at cheaper and cheaper prices. And by the time you come here, you would have made a fortune. Maybe
I didn't believe it.
Extra money.
I didn't want to believe it for the longest time. Like I didn't look at your Coinbase trading for a long time. And like even up until like last week, like I still didn't. But and you know what too? Now people are gonna say, because I said it too, like, well, if the market's bearish and it's going down, like you won't be able to, your core number, it'll go down. And so like, even if you lower your core number, it's okay because you're making money off of the trades, off of it going up and down. And like, so let's say 2 weeks from now, maybe Ethereum's down to $150 or $100, right? But I made all the money I made is money I've made swinging, boom, 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 boom. And so like at the end of the day, if you just like, if you try it, at the end of the day, you're going to have more money than what you started with. And yeah, it was cool.
It's so simple. Everybody looks at their account number all day and say, oh, I went up $700 today. And then
it's a hell of a lot safer than BitMEX. That's for sure. That's what everyone's been getting shit on.
They wake up the next morning and it's down $400. Imagine when it was up $700. You just took that $700, sold $700 worth of whatever shit token, okay, and put it aside. And then when the market went down, took that free fucking money that fell from the sky and put it back in. That's all it is. Anyway, bro, I don't want to keep talking about this. We can do consultations with people. My email's in the bottom. All they got to do is email me for rates. Look, it's not a lot of money. You can make it back on one trade. But anything else you want to say, face?
The consultations have been going great. I know this was kind of a short video. We just people been hurt on BitMEX. We were supposed to talk about do's and don'ts again of BitMEX, and I guess we got a little sidetracked. But don't go over 10x. You know, don't trade more than you can. Like, the consultations have all, every single consultation has been a home run, except for one. And I'm not even saying it went bad. It's just the kid was literally brand new into crypto, brand new to everything. And it's like he didn't even have foundation. He didn't even know what to click or what things mean. So it's like, oh, man, you know what I mean? After a month, he should have had a consultation. So consultations are great. I like doing them with you, man. We're supposed to have, I have one guy in particular that wants both of us today, and then I got two other people that are just me. Thanks for having me on the channel.
Something in there too. I want to tell people something. The biggest enemy in trading is you. And the truth of the matter is, you sit there. I know what you do because, look, at one time before I was the Oracle, I was human, okay? And I would put on a trade, and I would sit there and watch the numbers. And if it would start going against me, okay, I'd become like an idiot savant. I'd start freaking out and thinking I made a mistake. And then what do? I would sell it just like you are doing. I would sell it and say, fuck, okay. All right, I only lost 12%. Not bad, not bad. All right, but I want to get back in. And it starts going up. And then you feel it's going to run, like Ethereum's going to run straight to 305 today. This is in your head, okay? Well, if you see it going up a little bit, what do? You buy back in. Higher. You buy in usually higher. So here's what I can teach you. Most of the times, I want you to prepare yourself that the minute you put on a trade, it's going to fucking go against you. Think that way. And then if it doesn't, you'll be happy. But usually
be forced into the trade. Don't force yourself into a trade. Don't go in there trying to force something to happen. Just when you see a pattern or you see the stars align and it's like, I can't miss out on this. Think about not missing out, not forcing it.
Exactly. You don't have to put on a trade. You don't have to have your money constantly in the machine. That's what I want you to think about. Or else you get screwed. But the other thing is this. If you put in a trade and the amount doesn't terrify you if you lost it, close your fucking computer and leave
the house. So what's the good amount to make then, Oracle? What do you suggest? Because then what do you suggest, right? We tell people you're not going to double your money overnight every night. Like, in fact, that's what everyone should do, is write down. I know it sounds gay, but come up with a goal or a daily amount you want to hit, right? Like 1/20th, 5%. Shoot for making 5% or even 4% of your whole amount, not just a trade. Aim for a target. Make it small and safe. In fact, set a goal saying, I have to do this in no more than two trades. I'm only allowed to make two trades today. That's it. So I think everyone needs to write down and be serious. In fact, we should do like a little giveaway. In order for you to be in our BitMEX giveaway, you have to show us your goal sheet, what your goal is of how much you're really shooting for every day, not just flying by the damn wind trying to risk it all. What do you think about that? Should we think about something?
I don't want to read people's fucking goal sheets. You know what? They could send you their fairy tales and popcorn dreams. Let's just stick to the shit at hand, okay? I want them.
Thanks for shooting that down.
Overinvest, okay? I want them to be able to feel comfortable and walk the fuck away. Let me show you something. Here, look. You see this? Hold on. Get this ugly chart shit off my screen. I keep it simple.
I can't believe you shot down my goal. You know what? I understand. I got enough shit coming in too. I get whatever.
Look.
Write down your goals, people.
I threw this trade on before, 129,000 contracts. I'm down 7%, right? Do I give a shit? Am I going to sit here and watch this all day? Fuck no. My liquidation is 269. I'm going to go out, have a nice day. And maybe tomorrow I'll look at this.
That's terrible. No one should be doing this. The whole 25X thing. So you don't care. But for all you people out there, don't be having 25X unless you know it's a sure damn thing.
Listen, I don't play like PewDiePie. Okay. But to me, this is like, you know, me being conservative. Like, what's his name? What's that Swedish guy?
Sonny Dekree.
Yeah. Him. I don't know. I don't watch
our friend Sonny. By the way, Sonny, we had a good consultation. We're glad you
Bro, did you want to tell them?
Sonny Dekree walked away happy. Sonny Decree walked away happy.
You never know what's going to happen on YouTube. So, yeah, this look, what I'm trying to say, forget my 25X. Maybe believe it's 2X in your head. I'm just trying to show you that no matter what the trade is, you got to be comfortable enough to shut off your computer and go out and go meet some bitches or do whatever you're going to do with your day. Play with your children. Go to the park. Do whatever. Save a bird. Okay?
Yeah, go but do then, something. Yeah. Save a bird.
Yeah. Go find the BitConnect bot masturbating in the corner somewhere. I'm sure it's stuck. You've seen my AI videos, so you know I'm
going to go bar hopping, looking for a woman sitting by herself. And then go up and sit, not the seat next to her, but the one to the right or whatever.
No, you know what?
Yeah, leave one seat in between a space.
No. Listen, you see a hot girl sitting on a bench in the park and she's feeding the fucking pigeons, right? Just go over and sit on her lap and say hi. And throw your arms around. Okay? Oh, fuck. All right. Listen, one other thing. Hey, you know that there's going to be a fork of Bitcoin Cash again, bro?
When?
In November 14th.
Now, good. That means it's gonna be in October. At the end of October, that's it. None of those dates, guys, from the SEC, from anybody, whatever date they give you, it's gonna happen earlier. So what do you think is gonna happen? I'm a Bitcoin Cash believer. So what do you think is gonna happen?
Well, I'm gonna show you what happened to me last time. Okay. I got to Bitcoin Cash around this price. And on May 15th was the fork.
Is that when it went up to 1500?
Yeah, bro. No way. May 13th, I showed everybody how I sold out, right? So, and the funniest fucking thing is I buy their shit tokens, right? I triple my money and then I give them their shit tokens back, the fucking Bitcoin Cash, right? So it's coming up again and people are going to have this opportunity to triple their money. Is it guaranteed? No. Should you wait all the way till November to get a little Bitcoin Cash? This price is a fucking steal for many reasons.
Yeah.
And this is not financial advice, but it is what it is. Face?
Yeah, man. I started with Bitcoin Cash with the core number, and then I moved actually over to Ethereum because I noticed Bitcoin Cash, the spikes are faster. So if I'm meeting some bitch at the bar or something, excuse my language, that's not what I meant. Lovely women. No one respects women more than me. I don't want to hear shit from anybody. No one treats women better than me. Guarantee it. But I found that Ethereum like lasts a little bit longer on the ups and the downs. So it was easier for me to core trade.
Yeah. I don't do core trading on BitMEX. You know, I don't mix those two. Core trading is a separate thing.
I was saying, but with core trading, I started with Bitcoin Cash and then I moved over to Ethereum.
I split it between both. I find I get the best balance. That's my diversification in fucking crypto. Okay, those two. And I don't know if we should show. You know what? Hold on.
Go ahead.
All right, guys. Look, I'm going to show you my personal shit. I have no motive to show you this. Just like Crypto Face was just saying. Now, in a two-day period between August 21st and August 22nd, let's pull up my handy-dandy calculator.
So, by the way, when he paused it, he just paused it. He'd ask me, he's like, should I show him this, you think? And I said, yes. You don't have any motive. You're doing it yourself. You're not getting commissions off this. So, like, and if you're a hater, screw you. This works, and like single mothers can do it. If you're a single mother, you can honestly do this. And I have it. I had a single mother, so screw everybody out there. Single mothers, pay attention.
Wow, Face. I gotta tell you, man. I don't know if you're trying to get on my good side, or I don't know where this is all coming from. But I really didn't expect you to speak so highly of core number. Seriously, no joke.
I've been using it for 2 days, dude. For 2 days, so far, so good. And even in the bear market, like even with trading bots, right? Like the best I ever did was in bear markets. Everyone's like, oh, when it's going up, it's better. No, it's not. Things go crazy. Like, no, it works. If,
all right, so look.
But there is some explaining to do. So
in this 24-hour period, I ripped $8,801 between Bitcoin Cash and Ethereum. It just going up over my core number in 1 day. You want to know, when you talked about strippers, what'd you say, single moms or strippers? Or
single, I'm confused. Both.
Well, usually they're one in the same.
Same thing. I've
mostly heard. But that's why I go to, that's why I say we should all support single moms and go to strip clubs.
Strippers have sugar daddies, though, a lot of the times.
Oh, I don't know. I don't attend these things. You know, I'm usually at my Bible meetings and things like that. We're out.
They're the best neighbors. I tell you, strippers are the best neighbors to have because they love cooking. I used to live next to these couples, Christina and damn it, I don't remember the other one's name. I used to go in there, bro. I'd go in there and I'd be hooking up with this one chick and the other girl. This big fucking jacked black dude would be in there. So I'm, you know, it used to just be funny. Like, but like one's like a slender, skinny fucking Italian kid, white kid. The other one was this huge jack black motherfucker. Two opposite ends. We'd be in there smashing these strippers.
That's really hilarious, bro. But anyway.
Strippers can do this. Pay attention, strippers.
All right. So listen, yeah, pay attention, strippers. So the joy of this is your core number is just whatever you have in your account. All right. And so to make it simple for people, the reason why I say use the Coinbase app, you pull it out of your pocket while you're sitting in traffic or taking a shit at work, you know, hating your boss, whatever you're doing. Instead of being on Facebook, you look at your core number. If there's an extra $300 there, sell $300 worth of either one of these shit tokens. OK, this is just about you, for money for you and your family, and change your life. We don't get married to anything. And then you put that money aside. If you send it straight to your checking account, it's going to be tied up for a while. But who gives a fuck? You don't need to buy back in right away immediately anyway. And that keeps your core number identical. If you're going to keep that extra $300 and you had, let's say, a $4,000 core number, but you're only going to use it to your USD wallet, your Coinbase will still include that money. So you have to now move your core number up to $4,400.
So I think what you're trying to tell people is like how to adjust their core number, yes. Right? Okay.
Not do you mind if I... We'll save that for consultations because that's tricky.
All right. Oh, you're right, huh? So, okay.
Just had to see
I might want to do a video on this. God, you know what? It's, but yeah, we'll,
let's leave you here. You know what? Crypto Face. We gave them enough shit. This has been like a 27-minute video. We talked about crypto strippers. We talked about core number. We talked about not jumping off buildings, right? Or consultation.
I almost jumped out of my two-story. Are you jumping out of your one-bedroom apartment when you get Winklevoss?
That's what happens. On the first floor, you land on your kids' fucking boxers. Toys in the backyard, and the fucking hose is spraying in your fucking face, and your wife is yelling
your
at you.
Wife's
you
like,
break now?
Baby, what are you doing? He jumped out of his window because his trade went south.
In people's names, you know why? Well, we're doing something. I'm going to throw a shout out to whoever's fucking listening at the end of this. There was a YouTuber that I used to be at war with, and we made peace, man. And he has a fucking charity, okay? And I donated a little tiny nothing to his charity. What a good fucking dude this guy is. His name is Crypto Don. He used to be Ulysses Dardon. Okay, friend of Sean Walters. He goes back to the lending platform days. He's got a new site called Crypto Don. Go and subscribe to him, man. Really cool fucking dude. And we used to be big haters, man. It was in the blood. We hated each other. And he's a really good guy, man. He sent me some nice emails, and we laid down the weapons. And if he ever needs anything, he has a friend. All right, sorry for that fucking public service announcement. I'm tired of talking, Face.
Yeah, anyways. So the consultations have been going good. The haters are wrong. Most people understand. Everyone's been improving. Don't be going over 10 leverage. The Coinbase Connect thing works. But there is like a little bit of strategy behind it. And I'm ready to do some more consultations. I took a nice 10-hour sleep. You know, this takes a lot of energy out. My Discord people are always asking. I cut my Discord people off from Signals, dude. And I've gotten like more messages of people saying like, thank you and how appreciative. You don't know what you have till you lose it. You don't know what you have till you lose it. And that's why these guys are going 50X. They're starting out with 10X leverage. They get a couple winning trades. They think, man, their confidence is up. They push it 25-50X and then bam. And then they try to dollar cost average it and end up losing everything. That's what happened to your guy at the beginning of this video. It's happened to all of us. Me more than anybody. You know what I'm saying? So I get it. So stick to low leverage. Come up with a amount. You don't have to write goals. I never liked writing goals. But write down a number on a sticky note and slap it on your computer screen. Put it on your Jergens lotion before you do next to your paper towels. Okay? Wherever you're going to see it, make it achievable. Say no more than two trades a day. Because there's no more than a couple opportunities that you can safely get into per day. So if you're finding yourself doing 4 or 5 trades a day, you're risking too much. You're going to get screwed. Consultations.
It's so true, bro. All right, I'm going to wrap it up here. I'm going to give them fucking something to watch. Maybe some fluff or something. Or maybe nothing. They'll see.